end-stage kidney disease, in particular dialysis, tremendous impact on patient lives. So dialysis is offered typically 3 times a week in-center dialysis. So patients will travel to the dialysis unit, sit or lie in a dialysis chair as they receive dialysis treatment or cleaning of the blood. And then the recovery time after dialysis during a day can be many hours. And since this is 3 times a week, dialysis really is life-altering. So 3 out of 7 days a week are entirely shot or taken up by dialysis treatment itself.
What has been neglected over time is, what does the patient want? What are the outcomes that matter to the patient? And one of the key outcomes that does matter to the patient is the safety of the procedure. It is a procedure, it's an invasive procedure after all, dialysis. And so the PCORI grant that we recently were awarded is to study patient safety and do an intervention that will likely enhance patient safety. The traditional way of delivering dialysis in the US is short, intense dialysis sessions. And the incidence of what is known as intradialytic hypotension, which is blood pressure dropping acutely without warning during the session, is very frequent. And patients are at risk for complications, not just during the procedure, but due to the repetitive insult, they can have end organ damage that gradually gets worse and worse.
There's a lot of evidence to suggest that not only is our clinical outcomes, but also quality of life better with longer dialysis sessions. There is work going on these days, particularly at University of Michigan Keck and elsewhere at the CMS, with respect to development of measures that may ultimately incentivize longer treatment times. So this is another important area that DOPS is focused on with respect to important clinical implications and ultimately policy implications as well.